All right, we're here at Halverson's workshop. Behind me is the storage warehouse. Inside, they're keeping the new 120s and the existing 140Bs. And out here in front of me, we do have one of each. This is the much anticipated HWP 120. I am showing this model with the optional adjustable splitter head. This is the exact same head that fits in the 140B. And if you notice, the big back spine that's usually here is now eliminated, which means when this head is gone, you can actually cut the log to length and just process rounds without splitting them for your outdoor boiler. So with this head taken all the way out, you'll have a nice clean I-beam. So when that round drops in, it'll spit right out without ever being split. In the background is the 140B. I got them here side by side so you can see the differences between the two. Just do a quick little angle here on this one. Moving over to the 140B. As you can see, it's the same adjustable head. Here's that backbone, the back spine that I was telling you that it's now gone off the 120. Right here, this is gone, so it's a nice smooth, even tray when that splits out. Or so it'll spit out, I should say, around without ever being split. All right, notable changes. First off, the chain on this one is fully exposed. They've moved the saw motor to the inside of the case, so it's a lot easier to service and change the chainsaw chain. So this is what it looks like on the 120. Over here on the 140, there you'll see the saw motor on the outside of the case, which you do have to loosen these two bolts, top and bottom, bring this over for safety reasons, and then you can take the chain off and that gets the through shaft out of the way. Next notable change is the actual oiler bottle itself. It's now recessed down inside. This is the 140 where it's outside the case. The 120 is inside the case, so it's a little bit better protected. Next notable change is the actual grabber arm itself. We've changed the dynamic on this a little bit so it grabs the log a little bit better. And there's the grabber arm on the 140. The step-in plate is a little bit different. It's a lot smoother going across on this angle. You still get the punch-through plates for tread. Here. The front on the 140 is a little bit more open, leaving some hydraulics and hoses and couplers exposed. The 120, everything's all nice and safely enclosed. Looks like the front arms are a little bit shorter on the 120 versus the 140. Still get the yellow wrapping on the hoses, still get the flat face couplers. Again, our 120 is shown with the optional adjustable head. That is a $750 option over the standard fixed four-way wedge. The trough design down here is a little bit different. It's a lot shorter and it's got some holes, plasma torch through it, so you can see a little bit better when that piece of wood falls into the split versus the little bit taller, more cradle-like design of the 140B. Still have a very similar table angle. This is on the 140B. Here's the 120. again, overall great design, still a very, very heavy duty build. So just as a recap here, before I move on to the next one, this HWP 120, as it sits here with the adjustable head option on it, the price is $96.50 with the adjustable head option. As a straight four-way fixed wedge, the price is $8,900. Just to be clear on that fact. One last walk around before I go back inside. I'll do a couple pictures here and get those out on the internet as well. Fabulous, fabulous product. Couldn't be happier to offer this to the general public at $8,900 for the fixed four-way and $96.50 with the optional adjustable head.